begin, as always, with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have two excused absences. The chair is absent, and Councilor Thompson is under the weather.
And I do have some questions from Councilor Thompson that she emailed, so when they come up, I'll just read the questions that she has, so we can get them answered.
So what do we have left? We have Public Works and Grants?
Public Works, Fire, and then Grants.
Okay.
So there's about six, seven budgets to do.
Well, let's, without any further ado.
Page 41, Public Works Administration.
There's no big increases per se. I budgeted based on a normal winter. Remember last year, we had a very, very unusual winter. So when you're looking at actuals, you really couldn't even begin to compare that. And then we did have some issues where we held off on a lot of things to assist with some budget issues in other areas and other departments. So some things were pushed off due to that when you're looking at the actuals throughout this budget. I would just like to say right off. I had this up at 4.69%. I put the overtime up where it would be if we had a normal winter. Everything's based off what would be a normal winter on anything that has to do with winter maintenance. And the bulk of that is for winter maintenance.
I do have a question. Councilor Thompson was asking about a possible reduction of $10,000 from overtime. Yes, the year before was a unique year, and it was $75,000 in overtime. But in 13, you had, let me pull that up, sorry. You spent $47,000. In 14, it was about 58. And 15 was the odd year, which was the 75,000. Is it?
We're usually typically on average right close to the 50. We're really, really close to that 50, or just over. On a normal, what I call a normal winter, if you can call it that.
But. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Councilor Pike.
Yeah, and I would assume that if we're talking about trying to kind of do more road work, catch up a little bit and do more paving of roads and doing more work around town, that probably, you know, the more projects that are going on, does that drive overtime at all, or does it?
We typically send them home, or they'll take comp time, turn it into comp time per se.
Okay.
But there's a little bit from time to time. You just can't.
It seems like what I remember was the when you were working over on Elm Street with a sidewalk, and it seemed like you said at that time you needed to work sometimes later in the day than.
We did, but we can make it up on the end near the end of the week and go home early. Okay.
That was one of the policies we put into place, was that instead of straight overtime, we're going to do flex. Basically, end of the week, we'll shorten the schedule.
Okay, thanks.
Like the other night, everybody went home, but then Saturday night, we had that big storm.
Friday night.
Four people ended up getting called in and working pretty much all night. There's no way it's after the week, you know, there's no way to send them home after that, you know, and no one knew that was going to really happen. Mm-hmm. Things like that, you know, that's all.
Yep.
Those are the tough ones. And even with the snow, we typically send them home, but sometimes you just, It always seems to snow on a weekend.
Yeah. Councilor Weinstein.
Well, just with the numbers that the town administrator just gave us, I mean, it sounds like I wouldn't feel comfortable cutting it anymore. You know, I mean, it sounds like 50 is about right. We may go over that, but I wouldn't feel comfortable cutting it by 10.
So. Other comments?
General supplies, is it possible to reduce that to 7,000? You spent 55,28 the year before. Budget 8.
Do you have 15 there, Steve?
I can't pull it up.
That's just pen and paper, right? Like that sort of stuff.
15 was
8,854. four.
Yep.
14 was 8,400, but 13 was 4,244.
I would say, Steve, if you guys wanted to go 75 maybe, 75 versus the 7.
What do people think? People fine with that? Mm-hmm. It's really just $500 a day.
Yeah, I don't get too excited either way.
All right. Anything else on Public Works admin? Roads and sidewalks? Is that what's next?
Mm-hmm. Next page.
The roadways, like I said, I put in an increase for the asphalt for paving to 175 from the 155. Also, equipment lease, I was looking for a little bit more. That's the roadside mowing in some of the other little projects that we do where we hire outside equipment in the summer months.
You put it back down.
The curbside weed control is throughout the whole town, wherever you see granite curbing, we treat for that. If you don't, my best place I could tell you is to look at the bridge in Newfields next time you're driving through there, because that's what it'll look like all over town.
The reason why I reduced that one is we've only spent $950 each year for that.
There's one big jump.
Yeah. The addition of the, we zeroed out the sidewalk line last year. And he requested $90,000. I reduced it to $45,000. Basically, it's to finish the Bennett Way sidewalk, correct?
Yeah, to get up over the top. I'm looking at going up to the top of Bennett Way, completing mm-hmm. that circuit.
And
we went halfway, basically.
Sorry, go ahead.
What will 45 get you?
Like, you know where the top flattens? About there.
Okay.
Half of it, roughly. Half of that distance. So we stopped, when you go up Bennett Way, there's a flat point halfway up,
mm-hmm.
and then there's another flat point before it goes towards the stop sign. You'd get in the vicinity of that flat point.
Questions? Councilor Weinstein.
I guess my first thought is a comment, and I think that that's an important sidewalk to finish. It's used by a lot of people. I see the vehicle traffic in that area and also the foot traffic. I mean, it's certainly, I think, completely reasonable to have that as a plan. I'm curious what other sidewalks might be in our future. Any other?
Well, there's been some requests for a sidewalk along Grant Road, which you probably have heard about.
Yeah. Oh, Grant Road?
That's a state Rally. Road over there, obviously, with no sidewalk, but that request also, they've petitioned the town to not take care of the sidewalks in the wintertime in there also. So that's kind of, I have a tough time with that one, but we don't plow those sidewalks because they came to the town like 5 years ago and said, we don't want you plowing these sidewalks. And everyone in there agreed except for one resident, and they told me to stop plowing them, so we don't plow those sidewalks.
So what do they do? Each house takes care of their own sidewalk?
No, they don't do anything.
They don't do anything.
It just sits there. So
are they town sidewalks or are they their sidewalks?
They're the towns.
They're the towns. Understanding is that neighborhood petitioned one of my predecessors not to maintain them.
In the wintertime.
In the wintertime. Because they didn't want their lawns?
The snow pushed onto their off, which is in our right-of-way. Remember, our right-of-way goes way beyond the pavement.
Which is an mm-hmm. issue because we need to maintain our sidewalks.
Do we have a liability issue?
It's a safety. Yeah.
I didn't realize we weren't maintaining those sidewalks till after the snow this year. I've recommended to the Director of Public Works that we plow those next year because of that.
Can we just check?
Yeah.
We're going to lure in retainer. Mm-hmm. Can we just ask?
Oh, yeah. No,
is there a liability?
We'll ask our... insurance carrier.
Along those lines, can you also ask, I mean, I don't know how it works here with, in regard to sidewalks, but where I've lived previously that have had sidewalks, they were, the sidewalk was always owned by, like, the town. It wasn't owned by the property owner, but it was expected that the owner of the property took care of their sidewalk.
Correct.
So,
some places,
and any elderly people next to you, you would, you know, neighborly take care of theirs as well.
Some places do that, and actually, I believe Portsmouth fines you if you do not open it up within a certain amount of time.
Hmm.
So that's how they get the downtown ones all cleared up quickly. So,
have we ever thought about doing something like that?
I wouldn't recommend it on the Main Street sidewalks, because it's just the foot traffic that we get there. You could probably possibly do it on the side street, if there's enough. I don't think we have enough sidewalks in our system yet that we're stretched out when it comes to plowing.
Yeah. Right.
We don't have, like, every side street has a sidewalk situation.
Well, you have situations like Durrell, right? And even Elm Street, that there's not a property owner necessarily.
Right.
You know, the sidewalk in front of the cemetery, like, who, we kind of have to maintain that, right?
It's funny, because sometimes people get upset when we will delay or cancel school, and the roads might be somewhat okay, but you got to remember this.
Mm-hmm.
Miles and miles of sidewalk that might still be buried, and if we get a blow them, you know, that's also taken into consideration when that kind of happens, per se. But.
Councilor Pike.
Yeah, I'm just going to comment. You know, on the topic of having people just do their own sidewalks instead of having the town do it, I think the quality of the sidewalk clearing oftentimes isn't as good if people do their own, because you get some people are good about it, people do it at different times, and some, you know, some places and, you know, you're walking along and, oh, nothing shoveled here, you know, so.
It's like in the big cities more that kind of do that than the towns like Newmarket.
It's a neighborly thing to do, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Other comments? I will say, seeing no lights, I'd like there to see a sidewalk plan as opposed to just, like, numbers arbitrarily put in here. Like, what is, like, we have a road plan. Like, was there a plan for it? Obviously, we have less miles of sidewalk. They're smaller. They don't get beat up like a car beats up a road. But there should be some level of plan for, like, what we're doing with our sidewalks.
My intention is to do the same thing that we did for the roads for this until we receive a plan from Public Works that the money isn't released to do any more projects. This is 2 years out. So hopefully within this fiscal year and half of next, we can begin to actually have the plan in place.
What sidewalks are we doing this fiscal year?
I'm sorry?
What sidewalks are we doing this fiscal
year?
Zero.
We didn't budget. They cut it.
Oh, that's right. I guess I'll also comment that, well, I would love to see the Bennett Way done in 1 year. I think fiscally responsible to balance it out over two. I don't know, like.
Three. The only question I would ask is, does it add much to the cost of doing a project when you chop it up into little pieces versus doing it in a more complete way?
You sometimes, with the curbing, you'll get a better price if you're putting in more linear feet. When I say better price, it might be 20 cents less per foot, but it's a little bit.
Hmm.
But the curbing is the biggest place we would save.
Okay. Other comments on roads and sidewalks?
Just a comment. Is there any concern with the asphalt if we drop it we go with the 155? Because we have quite a big plan for streets.
The road maintenance plan has the in it that we only fund $155,000 each year.
Okay, it's
the,
so it's already
the increase in the capital reserve fund to offset it.
Okay.
And you guys actually increased that more than what we requested the other night.
Okay, so we're
fine.
Okay.
$155,000 is fine.
All right.
Yeah. Keep pushing the button.
That's Pike.
Is there anything? I guess it's okay. Councilor Levy brought, or Chairman Levy brought up and had a point that we don't know how long these oil prices are going to last, but they're definitely helping. So if there are reserve funds, I know you can't spend it automatically, but anything that moves that forward during our low period where we've got a lot of catching up to do on roads anyways may make some sense, if even if it draws down the reserve in that area.
I mean, 20,000 Does it, how much does that do for road?
It's not a lot in the grand scheme. If you're doing an overlay, yeah.
It's like nothing.
It would be like doing Phil's Road.
Yeah.
If it, you know.
Yeah. If
1,000 feet.
Raymond Lane. Yeah. Well, I don't own it. It's Towns Road, but yeah.
But on the flip side, if we were to increase the contribution to the Capital Reserve Fund and increase our withdrawal from the fund balance to offset that, that's another way to do it.
We did increase the Capital Reserve.
I know, but we could also increase it further, but also increase the withdrawal from the capital from the fund balance. If you want to do more roads this year.
You're saying don't contribute anymore, but take out more than we originally had planned.
I would say, I'm saying contribute more, but also we could, our fund balance is healthy enough that on the revenue side, we offset with an additional contribution by a withdrawal.
What's our fund balance at? 8%?
Almost 9.
Yeah.
That, what's our ordinance say we have to be within?
5 and 10.
We're like, at 8% to me is like right in the middle. It's just me, counselor. I just remember, probably the only one in the council that remembers when we had like the fund balance crisis and there were people with pitchforks and torches in here. I do not want to see that again.
Nope, that's fine.
Regardless of who's here.
But we're close to 9 now. What would it mean if we brought it down to 8? Or you're just not happy with 8?
I think 8, like, I'd rather see 10. This is just, again, just me. Just because I'd rather, like, because the crisis will hit. There will be something that happens. Like, that year with the pitchfork year I was referring to, like, there was this perfect storm where, like, a bunch got downshifted from the state because they were having financial issues. And then we had no fund balance to offset it because several councils before had, you know, I think well-intentioned, but, like, for whatever reason, like, had drawn it down to a place where we couldn't offset the spike, so we had, like, a double spike. Mm. To me, in the current, like, sort of financial world, the new normal, I just think you never know what's going to get downshifted from the state, and all of a sudden we're going to be, like, or the premiums go up, or something happens, and we get, that's just me.
Yeah.
And one person.
Yeah, I just, well, if it's like there are, asphalt's on sale right now.
Right.
And we've not been spending for a long
draw
time.
Draw more from the capital reserves? What's the capital reserves sit at?
Reserve.
Contributing more to a capital reserve to withdraw more is antithetical to the purpose of a capital reserve. That is literally using it as an operating fund.
Yep.
The municipal transportation fund, you can dip into that too for figuring in sidewalks.
Right. Matt, could you pull up the municipal transportation fund to find out what was in there?
I think it's 267 last time I looked at it.
So if we're going to gamble in the futures, like, we can pull just out more and pay more this year and just, like, you got to alter the plan, though, for future years, recognizing.
We can do that.
I'm not against that.
Yeah, that's fine.
And again, I'm just one person.
And the Municipal Transportation Fund? Sorry, where does that...
Matt?
Where do those funds come from? Yeah.
That's the $5 that we charge on your motor vehicle registration.
And that's to be used for roadways?
Yep, roadways or any transportation projects.
Sidewalks,
we've been
lots.
Using that for... 4 or 5 years now?
We dipped into it a few times for paving.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. I'd say do whatever we can to accelerate without blowing the budget because this
is
260 something.
Get it done. All right. Unfortunately, mine is just a little bit out of date. Wait a minute. Here it is. I have 174,000. But then I think there was another contribution after year end. Mine's as of June 30. So it's just a few months behind.
So there are funds that exist that can be like
absolutely
leveraged to like gamble that this is like the low point of.
Okay.
Cool. Other things on roads and sidewalks. Next.
Next page is.
Streetlights.
Shut them off.
There's no change in the budget. So, no issue there. The next is
big, like, is there? Because I know the question will be asked. Like, the actuals are like closer to 45. Is there a reason it's up?
For which?
Oh, you mean
electricity?
Rates are up. I don't have any. Yeah. Next are bridges and guardrails.
What in the world happened there?
Rick wants to buy guardrails.
Want to do some guardrail work, repair, update.
Where?
When did that be? Ashwamp Road, and we need to do some down on Lang's Lane. There's a big 4-foot culvert that crosses there, and on the right-hand side, it's someone.
Lang's?
Yeah. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the Velotica's. I think he's 90, 98 or 97 in that area.
Yeah.
There's a big culvert we did. There's a huge, someone ended up down in there, and it doesn't meet the requirements with the slopes and so forth. There's no guardrail there now, so we'd like to put some guardrail in over there and straighten out some guardrail. When you see, they call that W rail, because it looks like a W. When you see it getting the flat in it, the integrity's gone, so it won't hold a car back, so it needs to be repaired or replaced. The good news is when a car hits it, typically we go after the insurance. But on Lang's Lane, there's no guardrail currently in this location, and there was a pretty serious accident there last year. So we want to, it should have been guardrail there a long time ago, to be honest, but it just hasn't happened.
So Lang's Lane and Ashwamp?
On Ashwamp Road.
Where on Ashwamp?
At the bridge by Price's Garage. Yeah. That needs a little bit of repair.
Don't even notice it when you.
And the stuff we put in now isn't the wooden post, because those rot. It's all metal, as you'll see throughout. Everything's going metal now. So that's the other.
It's good because metal blends in with the landscape.
Make sure it's shiny.
That black stuff's real expensive.
The what?
The black.
Yeah. Thanks, Rickett. That one.
Any questions on this?
Just for the joke. We required him to buy black poles for downtown.
I just took a shot at Steve.
Yeah. So it matches the rest, and he was a little upset. Right.
We're not getting black for out there.
Buildings and grounds. I will take this one.
Yeah.
There is an increase of 14.67%. The largest increase is under full-time salaries, as I am proposing a new position for a director of facilities. The council should have received a memorandum outlining the reasoning for it. One thing that I would like to say for the logistics of it is that we would probably, you've already seen a memorandum of understanding that's a draft for the finance. Probably look at something similar for the school, for this position as well, because at this point in time, you don't know what exactly, you can't do hours because you don't know what the hours are going to be, and you don't know what's going to be on an annual basis. What we're looking at is that the personnel cost for the individual would be about $110,000, or about $65,000 for salary, and the rest is benefits, including health and retirement. We budget at the highest in case that they take the family plan. On the flip side, the school would reimburse the town in accordance with the same formula. So about 64% of that would equal to $70,400. The remaining 36% or $39,000 would be the town would be responsible for. What we would do is in fiscal year 18, 95% of that would be the savings that we could get from the finance director, because we're reducing that because of the shared services agreement if that goes in. And the remaining 5% would come from other areas of the budget. So we're talking probably about $5,000 that we'd need to find in the operating budget. They'd come through taxation. So on the opposite side, there is a revenue now for the school's contribution. So this is offset, again, by $70,400 as a revenue. I did a quick estimate of the value of just the buildings that we have combined in the town and the school. And this is going by our assessed value. And we have about $25 to $26 million worth of facilities in town. And we have no individual, one person dedicated to supervising it. Them. Many communities have, the school alone would have somebody as a building or facilities director. I, to be quite honest, I'm surprised that we don't. But this is a good way to solve that problem for both of us, to have somebody to oversee the facilities. Right now, it's a hodgepodge of really a committee with the public works director. There's a buildings and grounds supervisor, but it's a working foreman. He's the person in the field doing the work. The finance director and the building inspector get together, sort of have a conclave and come up with what they need to be done and what's the best plan. And this would allow, have one person to do it, come up with plans, come up with, do the RFPs that the finance director currently is doing, make sure contracts are being followed. I see it as a win-win, that our facilities would be maintained better, plus in the long run, hopefully we'll save money by having, not save money by making sure we plan correctly and be able to be proactive with fixing items.
Councilor Pike.
Yeah, I support this. I think we, one of the values and good timing was having, I know it's not fully public yet, but we've seen the draft of the MRI report, and the MRI report was highly supportive of having a facilities person. And I think it also pointed out that, there's somewhat of a bit of a reorganization in here of, some moving around of responsibilities that comes with hiring this facility person is also, and it also furthers the sharing of administrative positions between town and school. And I think the net result of when we get to the end of this process of, a shared finance, shared facilities, and maybe IT is that we'll, I'm hopeful that this will build more resilience. I think that the report we had was highly, highly favorable in terms of the many good things that are being done, the employees we have and the good work they do in the town, but pointed out that there's not much reserve in many of those functions. So, unlike the shared services on the finance side, where I think eventually, you may sort of build in efficiencies that way because you won't have to replicate every one school and town eventually. On this, I'm not sure that you're going to, see that kind of reduction, but I think a higher quality of services might result. You have somebody that's really looking for more long-term planning. I think it'll be important that the person, when they are hired, is, has, somebody that's going to be good at putting a plan together, good on their doing a good report on the computer, that kind of thing. So I think we've invested in a report that points us in this direction, and I think I think it's a good plan.
Other comments?
I have a couple questions from Councilor Thompson.
Oh, sure.
Senior Center Heat, why is there an increase?
Just went right off of that. I got more on this, but you can ask her.
Yeah, sorry. I didn't know you switched the
go ahead.
It should be a year. Do you know why I went for 5,500?
That's the new, that's a new one for us. We took over behind the senior center behind the police there from the, remember the housing used to pay?
That's okay.
Yeah, in 16 it was only a partial year. So we're going to really get the full impact in 17. So at this point it's still entirely a guess.
It's an estimate.
That's all right.
They don't like to be cold up there.
So my question is, philosophically, the buildings and grounds, I think, is a good idea. My question is, a full-time equivalent is 2,000 hours, right?
Okay. Yep.
So a percentage of, we're saying some of that work is just not happening right now. Some of that 2,000 hours worth of work that we need to have happen is just not occurring. But the other is occurring and other people are doing it. So I guess I have just a philosophical workflow question around, we are now reducing other people's labor from their assigned 2,000 hours of work. What is refilling that? Or what are we reducing in terms of positions elsewhere where this work is being repurposed?
What you're seeing the repurposing is, first, the finance director is one of the big ones. The amount of time that the finance director spends on issuing the bids, doing the bid documents for Buildings and Grounds is quite significant. Second one is the building inspector does a lot of Buildings and Grounds reviewing items, looking at best ways, best practices, and suggesting them. That would be, he would be spending more time doing the building inspections and code enforcement.
Can I jump into this a little
bit?
There are some projects that I really need to do that got delayed because of building projects.
Like?
Financial statements. That's an example.
We're not doing financial statements?
We are. They're late.
How late?
I got them today.
About 2 months.
Code enforcement's part-time.
Correct.
But we're going to assume he's doing the same hours next year or in 2 years, even though a percentage of his work is going to someone else.
Correct. And he would be doing that. He's not being proactive, and he'll admit it. A lot of he's doing the building inspections, but the code enforcement side, it's reactive, not doing some of the other types of inspections, like some of the food inspections, some of the building inspections that you know where apartments are. We just don't have enough time to do those. He's doing reactive ones when he gets a phone call, but some of the proactive and his assistant people that way, he's not. And it's mainly his building inspections that he's doing when he's not.
I'm all for the position. I just want to make sure that we're not just adding a body. We're actually looking at labor in terms of tasks and ensure that they're we're doing this the way a business would do it.
Oh, absolutely. And that's, I thought about that myself on our side, and those are the big ones I see on our side. I know on the school side, they're looking at, they don't have that one person to, they have an individual overseeing basically each building, but nobody doing the grand plan for the district as a whole.
Yeah, I mean, the school side's a whole nother, but yeah. I have no venue
and
to
we don't have, and we are really not doing that either. We don't have that grand plan as a whole, saying, okay, we need to get all the boilers, I'm just using this, I'm not saying we do, all the boilers replaced, let's do it at the same time in the same types of boilers, so if one goes down, we have pieces or parts for all of them, and it's a continuous system. We don't have any of that planning going on.
Councillor Weinstein, then Councillor Pike.
I just think it's also important to note that we're not looking at a full-time position. I mean, it's a full-time position, but not for the town necessarily. We're looking at 40%, right?
Yeah, we're looking
we're not looking
800 hours.
Or, yeah, so I think that that's that makes a big difference. A lot of that time will be
there's a lot of things that I'm going to pick on them, but John Holpeck's position, it just doesn't happen. It's just only so many hours in a day, and so many things that need to, and you have to prioritize, and mm-hmm. you get to what you get to. And he's only one person, and there's a lot going on. Mm-hmm. There really is, I'll say, I know Matt helps out a lot, and Mike, but John's position needs to be more another notch, like you're talking about. It really does. And he can't do both. He just can't.
Anything else, Councilor?
Yeah, I'm more along the lines of the same thing. I think we are talking about hours being put into something that's not currently being done, because I know on the 4 years I've been on the council, sometimes it will come up and we're asking for a level of analysis around some kind of a building or spending project that it just has not been in, it's not what we get, and I don't think we're going to get it unless we have somebody that's really looking more comprehensively, and that's what they do. And I think if we when we get that, I think it's a sort of a step in faith, because you don't know that, we've been getting by without it, but I think people that have more experience in the building maintenance that are professionals in that area say that there are opportunities that over time, if we have a more long range and a better vision of what we're trying to accomplish in terms of maintaining this part of the town, what the town owns, that we're going to save money in the long run. You're not going to find yourself, you're going to get better product.
Like I said, I'm not philosophically or functionally opposed to us having a buildings and grounds person. I just question, I just don't understand the math behind, and I get that we're only the 36% of it. The math behind the hours. But I'm one person. I'm not like.
I would just say, I hear you. I think it would be, we always would like to have a better analysis, but I think sometimes these things are, they're hard. I wouldn't know how to do that analysis. But I think we've got a lot of recommendations to proceed in this direction, and I'm willing to take a step in faith. Go ahead.
We never quantify the hours that the building inspector, Matt, or people who wouldn't be doing it normally are in the building, doing the buildings and grounds. We knew it needed to get done, so we just do it. So we wouldn't have those figures that say, you know, the finance director spends exactly 1,800 hours a year doing buildings and grounds. I'm just throwing a number out, versus the building inspector does 2,200. We don't have that because we just know these things need to get done. It's just we see the vacant, that, and the bigger problem is that those people are putting hours in to do it, and they should be doing other things. So.
And there's a level of expertise there. For example, I went down to the library with the library director, and we were looking at the facade of the building, and we thought that it's twisting away from the building. We had an engineer come in and say that it was actually safe. He thought it was safe, and you know, that was experience that we just didn't have.
Councilor Bowden.
That was fun to, I guess, piggyback off of what Rick had mentioned about John Bohopic and things trying on as far as what he's doing for the town for the fields maintenance. I mean, being personally involved with the Newmarket Youth Athletic Association and softball. He's down there whenever he possibly can. And we're down there trying to get him down there to correct issues with a field that was, you know, maybe not installed correctly, but he's down there and he's doing a great job. But being proactive rather than reactive are two very different things. And if it's something that has to do with the code enforcement, with restaurants or looking at that, what happens if we're not going in and checking on a restaurant and somebody gets ill?
How many complaints have we had about that in the last 2 years, 5 years?
I know of four. I'm not sure what the building inspector has separately. So. I've only been here for.
I'm just one person.
About 1 year.
All right. I guess the point I'm trying to make is almost as much to do with every position we have as this one, that like work tasks take a certain amount of time. Like any business would build up from their personnel roster based on the amount of tasks they're trying to accomplish in a year. Maybe we have too few, maybe we have too many, maybe like, but I feel like it would benefit the community if we took a more scientific approach to like how we staff our organization.
That is all, yeah.
Right, but we did have a consultant come in and look at that across there, you know. So it's not like we've just, you know, we've been haphazard in our approach to this. We've had a consultant come in, they've made a few very strong recommendations, and we have an opportunity to defray the cost, but trying to not meet those needs by doing it apart from the school, but to do it in an integrated fashion. I think you could maybe do more of that analysis, but as I've made the comment before, there's some urgency around this. The school has put the money up first, and they're anxious to get that person in place because, you know, they're looking at a huge ad reno project, and they, you know. So I think it's not the ideal way maybe of laying this out and considering it, but I think we're trying to do it and and plan it, or you know, do it and intellectualize it at the same time. You know, that's kind of tricky that way.
Councilor Weinstein?
And that was basically what I was going to say. And I think, I mean, this is for fiscal year 2018. So, I mean, we are looking a little bit into the future. And unfortunately, we want to put some things in place now, even though the plan may not be completely fully formed, but we need the budget piece in place in order to fully form the plan. So I certainly support it.
Councilor Burns.
I just wanted to add to what everybody's saying, but you know, with the MRI, and it's not published yet, is it?
No.
So, I mean, the recommendations were in there as well, that we need to do this. So I think with the opportunity presenting itself and with the sense of urgency, I think it's the right time. Again, maybe there could be lots more analysis, or not a lot, but more analysis that could be done. But I think with the consultants that we had, I would be comfortable with that.
Mr. Minister.
Looking at oil, Matt, we didn't expend Young's Lane last year, which is highway and fire. We budgeted 39, we only spent 27. 26 for town hall, we spent 21. Can we got the bid prices in.
The bid prices are for this year, and yeah, they're actually less than last year. So last year is at a higher rate. If it goes back up, I'm thinking it may go back up to where we were last year at the most.
So it'd go up to like 27?
So for town hall, if it's at 21, but then again, also it was a warm year. So, you know, it may go up to 22, 23.
But if we reduce, say, town hall to 22.
Yeah.
I mean, we know oil's one of those things that it's a hit or miss. But I mean, if you look at actuals for the past couple of years, it's closer to 22 than it is to 24. So I would recommend reducing that one to 22,000. Go to Young's Lane, which is my highway and fire. Mm. I'd go down to 30. So there's 7 right there.
Anyone have an issue with that?
No.
All right, there you go. Anything else on buildings and grounds?
I do have something.
Councilor Weinstein.
Elevator maintenance? I was just curious.
The one out here?
Why?
Where
is
that?
25
to 3?
Oh, no, sorry. I'm looking at different numbers.
Yeah, actually, the contract for elevator maintenance went up just a little bit. So I think 3,000 is probably in line.
Why does it say 20%?
Because it's 20%. It went up from 2,500 to 3,000.
Oh, okay, sorry. Yep.
And just so you know, because there's one that's 1,020%
is
the clock. That's our lease payment for the church to host our clock.
Anyone else on buildings and grounds? Mm-hmm. Next up.
I have one thing. So, because I know it comes up. Are you going to be able to, when is the what's the hiring schedule looking for the facilities person at this point? I know we've talked, it was part of our conversation before.
Yeah, I mean, my feeling is I would like to have a budget approved or be close to it to get through the process. Because if for some reason a budget doesn't go in and we hire somebody before the budget, then we have to let them go because we don't have it in the budget after.
Right. So when, what date is that the budget will be approved?
March.
That's much different than what we talked about.
If the council wants, I mean, that my feeling is I don't want to hire somebody and not have the money in it. After, well,
and this
them.
Is
starts this on is July 1.
The July 1 budget.
Right.
So there's not even, is there money to pay for someone?
The school has $50,000 to pay for somebody in this fiscal year. And they've been willing to share that with us.
Right. So they would fund it this year, and they you know, in sort of the spirit of this, we are making this higher. So them, they have the budget there and a great need for it right now. So if this, I think if we lay out our intention, waiting till March is really going to be.
Yeah, I mean, we can go earlier. I just wanted to be known that if the budget were to fail for some reason,
there'd be no money for that.
There'd be no money for that.
Right.
That human being who has that position would now be told, you don't have a job anymore.
Unless the school wanted to fund it.
Right. And I think right now.
They would work for the school, not for the town.
So he just said something, though, that's peered my ears up. Who's doing the hiring for this?
This will be a town position.
So, but much like my comments with the finance director, mm-hmm. like what kind of joint groupings of individuals are going to be on the committee to hire this individual?
Once we get to that point, we'll follow the charter appointing a department head.
And this is an adjustment of our organizational structure.
That's correct.
The council have to vote on that as a whole.
You also
council.
Have to do an
There's not the budgeting process. Nope. It is an actual vote.
You'd
to
actually
the
have
structure.
To do a, to amend the administrative code, which needs a lot of amending, but yeah, we have to amend the administrative code.
Okay.
Because basically you're taking the buildings and grounds out of public works and, as the chart shows, promoting it to its own department.
Yeah,
which is a whole conversation I think that should be had during the mm-hmm. admin code conversation, not the budget one. Like whether that's
right, that's fine. But I think we should talk about putting. I mean, I think we should have a conversation about what the timing would be, so we can be transparent with the school. And
if my first step was to get through here,
right,
and I, right, you know, then my next step is go through the budget committee. Then I'd feel more comfortable saying, okay, school, I've got through these two hoops.
So when will this go to the budget committee then?
We're going to have our meeting on the 28th of November.
Okay. But it would probably be safe at least, in what format would the town council discuss the change in the administrative code?
I bring an amendment to the ordinance.
It's an ordinance.
Okay. So we, because I'm saying, can we start that process? I feel personally confident that the budget committee is highly. I think this makes so much sense. I don't think it's going to be turned over. We're not hiring the person, but can we at least start the ordinance process?
Yeah. But again, it doesn't necessarily. And even at the end of the day, that ordinance may fail. But we could still hire a person to do this position. It's just we're not creating that new Department of Buildings and Grounds. It's just somebody overseeing it under the Public Works Department.
So you can add the we have to look at the charter. The administrator can add a position without the council saying
yes.
So?
I can't add a department, but I can add a position because it's in the budget and you're approving it in the budget.
You wouldn't be able to add the position until this budget was acted on July. I'm just trying to make sure we're legal on all this.
Yeah, no, I can't do it until July 1. Unless I have an unanticipated revenue, which would be a contribution from the schools.
If we put an ordinance up, it would pass.
Well, that's what but we'll be fine. But I'm just saying that to get to what Councilor Pike's asking, we can start, I'll probably have the first reading on November 16th. You could adopt it on the first meeting in December. If not the first meeting in December, first reading, second meeting for a vote.
Right. So is it going to be possible to begin to post this position, to advertise the position?
Not until the position's, the department's created.
We're going to do that until on.
You guys have to vote in.
On December, the first meeting in December.
Either or.
Right. I'm assuming it's going to pass.
And again, I also want to reiterate, hiring process right now, I have a vacancy on January 1 that I need to fill. That's my priority right now. It's not the facilities director.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I hear.
So you. I'm not rushing the facilities director position, trying to hire that by January 1, because I have to hire a rec director by January 1.
Right.
Because that's somebody leaving.
So if I hear all of that, but again, just to be transparent with you know, we're moving towards one town, and they ought to know what this schedule looks like.
And the superintendent and I have talked about it.
Okay.
She knows what the priorities of hiring right now are. Like, for example, the last time was, I need to hire a police chief. That was the number one priority at that point in time.
So on the schedule we're talking about, the ordinance vote, first meeting in December, would you then be able to, I understand that you're trying to work for January 1, but you met on your rec director. Do you anticipate that you would be posting this position in December? I mean, it's kind of right onto the holiday. You do? Okay.
Yep. I'd probably have it, and we'd be open till mid-January. Then we do the interview process, bring them in. Probably by the time we bring them in, we'll know exactly what the budget's going to be.
Okay.
Just because the hiring process is not like in the private sector. It's not a two-day.
Not every company in the private sector.
Yeah, I know. So, I mean, we got to have a certain amount of time. Because if not, I mean, you get accused that, you're only keeping it open for a week because you know who you want. And we don't want that. No. That's one thing I don't want to do, which we try to have it fair.
No, that's good. We've got a schedule now. Yeah. That's helpful. So that's good.
Anything else? Next.
Cemeteries. Next page. I do have a question from Council Thompson from this one. What's up with the $6,800 additional or the big increase in part-time salaries?
Mm. In contracted services.
That one is they're replacing a gate.
Cemetery trustees wants to do some work to the town cemetery up there behind the police station. Needs a gate and some stones.
Oh, no, I've been back there. I know. There's
some stones. They want to replace some stones over there.
Don't they have a trust fund?
They do.
It was their request. That's why it's in there.
Do they have a trust fund?
They do.
Yeah.
How much is in it?
Matt?
It's going to be a minute. I was trying to answer the other question.
The salary question?
Yeah, but
I guess we can start there.
Yeah.
The cemetery gates? Which one? Which cemetery?
The town cemetery off of Terrace Drive.
Behind the police station?
It should be called. Oops.
I'm sorry. I turned it down.
Oh.
Is that their capital reserve?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yep.
Come on. All right, you can't scroll it down.
It counts.
It seems like that spreadsheet is locked up.
Yeah.
Which one are you looking at? Cemetery? Are you looking at the salaries or are you looking at the trust fund?
The trust fund. Trust fund.
Let me go back to salaries, and it's locking this one up, too.
It's locking.
My computer just went
froze.
Froze.
Well, I guess we got to pass everything, because Matt's computer. Can you restart your computer?
Control delete.
Close the program.
Can we talk about, another department while he figures out what's wrong with the computer?
Vehicle maintenance.
That's the next page. A decrease of 1.69%.
Savings in fuel and gasoline.
Questions?
All right, next.
Fire and rescue, increase of 5.07%. The fire chief, we gotta get the fire chief in.
Changing your hats.
He requested an increase of 7.35%. I reduced it.
The biggest change here is the fire department's extremely busy. The call volume continues to rise, and the bulk pretty much all of this increase is the part-time salaries. I was looking to increase the per diem shifts for the weekends. We currently just do that through the summer months, May to October. Looking to do it year-round because of the staffing issues and the calls for services is extremely, extremely busy, high. We're up like 6%. And that's what that increase was. Training is up, just trying to cover the cost for training, keeping people certified in recerts for their EMS licenses. And the equipment purchases was just a, we've got a lot of stuff that really needs some attention. Hoses and pagers and equipment needs. Steve chopped it back, but the fire department budget has been a tough one to maintain. As you can see, it's all based off calls. That's driving the cost here.
This is one of those situations where, yes, it does go over, but if you get an ambulance call, we get a revenue, but you can't put one against each other.
Mm-hmm. So. Councillor Pike.
Yeah, can I go back to the vehicles just 1 second?
Sure.
Maybe I just wasn't hearing when you said it, but the gasoline and diesel fuel was essentially in for this fiscal year 2016 was 30 grand about, and the budget for fiscal year 2018 is 49,000. Am I missing something? But that seems right to me. So we're
49.
Where are we looking? Where's
gas and diesel?
Oh,
together?
You're combining the two. Oh,
combining
those two numbers because they're both impacted by oil prices. So if you take that combined number, it's close to 50,000.
Yep.
And this year we're spending 30,000, and nobody's really that I know of is who knows, but they're not really projecting that kind of an increase in fuel prices.
We didn't push any snow though.
Oh, that's.
But I still think you could probably drop it by 9,000.
Okay, I'll take it.
Go to 10 for gasoline and 30 for diesel. You're right. I mean, we didn't push snow, but we're also at, instead of high threes when we did push snow, we're at low twos.
And the projections really aren't that there's going to be any big increase right away.
There isn't for gasoline. So what we'll do is we'll take gasoline down to 10,000 and diesel down to 30.
Anyone have an issue with that? All right, let's do it. Thank you, Councilor Pike.
Back to fire and rescue.
Fire and rescue questions.
We're still covering the town with just two full-time people in this department, too. The rest is all just call people. And the numbers are dwindling. I will tell you, we're doing a campaign right now to try to get more people. We interviewed five last night. And the trouble is some of them just don't make, you know, they come in and they don't make it. It's very challenging because we're so busy. It's hard to have a full-time job somewhere else or a wife and a kid and have that thing going off every six times a night. The fire department is honestly out of control. I've never seen anything like it. We typically, just to put it into perspective, do like 70 to 78. A busy month would be like low 80s. We're doing 106, 118, 112 every month. It's just, you think it's going to end and it just gets even busier.
My question is about equipment. Obviously, I think it's important that you're maintaining equipment and have the proper equipment. So for equipment maintenance, that line item, we spent almost 20 in 16, which was over the budget. I'm curious what we spent in 15.
Excuse me real quick.
Oh.
Yeah.
So
and at the fixed pay one,
Basically, that's the equipment maintenance was, that's the radios, the portables, the pagers, those types of things. The vehicle is under Public Works, so when you see that, that's just fire equipment, the SCBAs. But we did get new ones. We did buy the new SCBAs, mm-hmm. so there were a lot of repairs going to those, I will say that. And we did buy the new ones, so that's that will help. The biggest thing is the radios and the portables. They're just old, and we try to buy a couple at a time, and unfortunately, they're expensive.
I guess my question is 15... Are we just going to overspend that? Like,
well,
is 15 enough?
With the new air packs, I want to say we may be okay. Because
okay.
we have the new air packs. We were having a lot of issues with with the packs.
And then my other question is about equipment purchase. And so you had put in 60. It was reduced to 25. We only spent 11 in 16. I'm just wondering where we're at with that and what the
only reason I didn't spend, because I had to hold the line because I was so out of whack with salaries. So I didn't buy a lot of stuff because I had to, that's the only place I could hold the line.
And that's a request that I made of him.
I had to.
Right.
It's the only line item in the fire department where I can, and I typically don't do my equipment purchases right away just because of that. We wait till we're, you know, 6 months at least through the year. And we already knew we were in big trouble, so.
So again, I guess my question is 25 gonna? You requested 60, so I'm.
It's a big difference.
I'm curious if you're gonna get by with 25.
We do what we have to do. I'd love to have it be more, but.
Right, there's also a capital reserve fund.
Okay.
That we just put. How much should we put in there?
Okay, I think we knocked down. No, Public Works, we knocked down.
It's 300, yeah, we did.
There's a $500,000 engine in the cycle for 2019.
50,000.
50,000.
Quints aren't 500,000.
Huh?
Quints aren't 500,000.
It's not a quint. An engine, I said.
I heard what you said, but I said quints aren't 500,000.
It's 750.
Council Pikes.
Yeah, not to take us away from the budget per se, but in somewhere along the line, have you mentioned the stress of that, you know, sort of it's hard to have enough of your volunteer positions that, you know, your that was the conversation, the report you were just giving us was that, you know, the workload for the department is going up all the time, and it's hard to stock it with a volunteer, but it's happening right now. And again, we've referred to the MRI, the report that will be public soon, and they sort of are telling us that we're fortunate that we're still able to make a volunteer fire department work here. Mm-hmm. So, but I think one of the things that was advocated for in that report, and that, again, not the thing we'd be doing tonight, but they did say we need to have a better understanding of what the contingencies are. You know, is there an incremental thing we could do in the future if we're keeping, not tonight again, but if we're going to keep, if the volunteer fire department's going to continue working, what would be the next step if you had more, you know, if you were asking too much of your volunteers and had to do something else? That would be not necessarily a question for tonight, but I think at some point we want to look at those.
I mean, people have comments. Personally, that one of the reasons I support the adding money to the part-time salaries is to prevent that exact thing from happening. That like we're help taking care of them better, so that we don't find ourselves in that position where we have to all of a sudden start hiring more full-time equivalents.
That's exactly what we're doing.
This is like, it's pennies on the dollar what we'd spend if we had to.
Well, I agree. I just want to make sure that that we take care so that we stay within our capabilities. Don't overstress the system, so to speak.
It's really, in the last 6 months, it's just really, really taken off. And it's been busy, and we're doing a pretty good job covering the calls.
Right.
Sometimes stuff doesn't get covered, whether it's just because something's out of service, where we have the two ambulances. We just put the new one in service, so that's helping. The other one was out of service more than it was in. But we're trying to get creative in ways to, like, retain people and not burn them out and have burnout, is what we call it. And it's something that Deputy Chief Barr's been kind of working on very hard and coming up with creative ways to make it.
Yeah, I hear you. Appreciate the efforts.
Other fire questions? What's next?
Emergency management.
Huge budget line.
Yeah, it's up 53%. We're going to start updating the emergency management plan. Hasn't been updated in at least 5 years, and it needs to be done. We hope to get a grant to, but you need usually some kind of contribution to it. So that's why we're including $1,500 in there.
Questions on that?
General.
Councilor Bowe, go.
General supplies department had proposed 450. Todd and Min proposed 1,500.
Yeah, that's where the grant is going to go, come out of that line. And not the grant, sorry, the updating of the plan.
Next.
Back to cemeteries.
Cemeteries.
Back
yeah.
You're all set for
cemeteries?
Can
we start your computer?
Yeah.
Rick, okay. Do you need to go?
No, I just if we can do cemeteries, then go to solid waste so I could?
Yep.
Solid waste. Yeah. All right. The reason why it's at 14,000 for the part-time position is because I have that position at a 26-week seasonal position. What I've been hearing from the department is that they need additional time to get the work done, to start earlier in the spring for spring cleanup and work later in the fall. So that's what the 26-week
This got cut a few years, well, I say a few years ago. It was probably back five before Steve even was here. That got cut back a long time ago.
But if you look at actuals from 2016, it's only $7,600.
Let's see, let me go back.
It was 11.
That was the budget.
Yeah.
It was 11, but the actual usage of this.
Right, and then 13, it was 3,500. Mm-hmm. 14, it was it was 10.
Okay.
I would suggest reducing that to. Sorry, I've got to close up something. I'd go back to 11.
I mean,
1150.
Like.
I mean, there were years that it was closer to the 11, but you're right. Last year was. But last year also, though, didn't we have snow later in the season?
We did. The person's not working probably like when they really would. They're coming and starting is on, we're just dealing with it, you know?
No.
We want them back. We want them back, you know, late March, early April, and they're coming in 2 weeks before Memorial Day.
Got it.
And they're going home too early. We're doing the fall pickups in there, not this person, with what we have, the staff. And we're trying to have this person do that. And they haven't been. If you look at actuals, this person's only working basically May to October, not April to Thanksgiving.
Yeah, that's why I see that.
So you mentioned a 26-week year. So you're looking to increase the position? Is that what?
Well, that's what the 14,000 is. Okay. Is to bring it up to 26 weeks.
Okay.
Again, the work's getting done, right?
Yeah.
Are we in a crisis position where something's not getting done
because
of this?
It's very stressful.
Don't Rick, smile when
I
you
am
say
incredibly
it.
Concerned about your peace of mind.
That's what's a laugh when you say it, right? $11.50?
$11.50 it is.
Apparently.
Okay.
Anyone have an issue with that? We're solid waste.
No, we got one. You wanted to know about the gate.
Oh, the gate.
I don't know the name of the cemetery, so I can't find.
Oh, you know what?
I just wanted the trust. Yeah, the amount of trust.
How much is in the trust fund?
I have all the trust funds in front of me.
But each one has its.
Each cemetery has its own.
Right.
Yeah, so I don't know the name of the cemetery.
Like, well, I know the name of the other two. It's not Riverside.
Calvary.
It's not Calvary, so it's the other
Calvary.
One.
He always calls it the Old Town Cemetery. That's how they refer to it to me.
So if we have three cemeteries and we said two of them are out.
Stone.
It's the third. It's whatever the third one.
He's typing.
He says Old Town.
Matt, you said you have three cemetery trusts?
Oh, no, there's several of them. There's also private graveyards.
Yeah, they do hold private cemetery trusts.
I feel like we're overcomplicating this.
I know.
How about the stone?
It's got to be a large one.
Yeah. I have Riverside and...
It's not Calvary.
Calvary.
So whatever the next biggest one is.
Next biggest one? It would be Calvary.
No, yeah, after Calvary. Not Riverside or Calvary.
It's called the Old Town Cemetery.
Yeah, I would have to have someone point it out.
You don't have the trust fund?
Yeah, I have like private graveyards.
No,
someone call Ed.
Let's see if it's in here.
Field trip. Want me to put him on speaker and we can ask him? He's the guy.
No, you can't. That's not legal.
Sorry.
It's not
this is Michael Pelzer. That's
well, tell him to ask his dad what the name of the center.
There he is, and it's not the name that we go by.
Yeah, that's one that I can't match up the trust to the cemetery. So
then do we cut this 5,000?
Like, yeah, why are we like...
And why
so
we
we're just
going to
budget something
we
because we can't find the documentation?
I'm sorry.
We're budgeting $5,000 more, but we don't know if they have money in the trust fund.
But we're not offsetting that increase by money from the trust fund.
That's the point. We could withdraw money from the trust fund to do this
Great
project.
Hill. Great Hill?
Unless the trust fund's like empty, then
right.
we have
right.
to do it. But so
we
not
don't have an answer from the trustees.
Making a decision based on no facts.
Can we get that information?
How about Great Hill Terrace? Do you have that name?
You get that information because you got to vote on the budget for the next meeting anyway.
But do you have Great Hill Terrace?
No.
That's name in the cemetery.
Well, like Councilor Weiss is right. Like, can you get it and vote on this on Tuesday, on next Wednesday? That's the 2nd of November. I know you have to have it by the 15th.
Do you want to do that?
This is for a gate. You can
we
always
know
delay a gate. A gate isn't something that you need
to
do
so
right. for 1 year.
Five.
Yeah.
Mike said there are individuals up the individual lots, and
nope.
There's no funds.
Okay.
So there is no trust.
No trust, he said.
Oh, there's no trust.
But there's trust at the Riverside Cemetery for headstone repair.
Riverside, different, but the
right.
Old town.
Well, you can do 5,000. There's 5,000.
There's 5,000 that goes to the gate, then the trust
Riverside,
at Riverside takes care of the grave site repair.
Right. And shouldn't that be perpetual care anyways? So, yeah. Yeah, 5,000 is fine.
Okay.
Solid waste. That is on page 56.
What do you got?
Increase of 4.61%. The council did approve the new contract for recycling and MSW. So that's where you see the 5.26 and the 1.23% increase. And the rest is the post-landfill task that we have to do every year. Engineering firm goes out there. I think there's anything else that sticks out. Oh, general supplies. Yeah, why is 25,000 general supplies?
That's the trash bags, the orange bags, and recycle bins.
Thank you.
Are we just spending more on that?
Buying more bags. Buying more bags and recycle bins.
Great.
Which we get
the revenue. That
revenue is offset. Yeah. Okay. Other questions on solid waste? Or any questions, that's all.
Okay. Next is grants.
Chief, or...
Chief and Public Works Director.
Public Works Director, thank you so much, Rick.
Thanks, Rick.
Hey, thanks for all the work on Ash Swamp. I cannot believe how quickly that happened. I thought that was going to be like a couple weeks.
Now, I'll spill your coffee, huh?
Surprise drive down that.
We don't encourage people to fly down that road.
Especially the town seals.
Black Jeep.
All right.
Grants.
Grants, what page?
Thank you.
One thing got added, festival support.
Yes, and the festival support is, we were not doing, we cut the festival support in the years past. The rec department requested that it be placed back in because they're trying to reactivate a festival. We had two in the past. They want to do something again, that they're going to try to spearhead it and try to get community people to run it.
Great.
But they want some feed money, so that's why it's back in.
Anything on grants? Social service grants.
Next page. 0.64% increase. It is the addition of the Child Advocacy Center. It has gone up to $1,000. And a grant for the Crossroads House, which is $1,000. That's the homeless shelter in Portsmouth that we use. And Richie McFarland is asking for $4,000. This is what each of the agencies. For those who don't know, what we do is they need to apply for funding to us, and we ask them for their financial statements for past 4 years.
Yes.
Plus how much money that they actually get goes back to the residents of Newmarket, and how many people in Newmarket actually use it. So we've started a pretty thorough process of looking at it. Those who did not, Link Together request, did not request funds this year.
Because?
Really?
They don't want them.
They don't want it.
Really?
Because?
They said
they're solvent for the year.
And they don't need assistance.
They are.
They're doing
great
good.
Members of the community.
Doing good.
They're doing good.
They're just not trying to build good. Like, they're just like, we're doing all right.
Yeah,
we
don't need it.
Good on them.
So. I'd rather save their goodwill for a year in which they need it.
Thank you, Link Together.
Okay.
For all you do.
It's not a negative that they don't need it. That's a positive. That
right.
Oh, yeah, it's
no,
good.
Yeah.
It means they're solvent. Councilor Weinstein.
I just have a couple comments. The Child Advocacy Center, I think it was here that Chief True talked about their need to use that service more and more and more. And so it makes sense to me that we're going to make a contribution to that. Same with Crossroads House and Richie McFarland, for that matter. I think that the increase. Now, this says the department had proposed 6 and town admin proposed 4. So did they request 6?
Yes.
Okay. And so we're going to increase it by 2. As someone who has received services from Richie McFarland Center, I have to say that it's a huge benefit to the kids who are under 3 who need services in the community. So I absolutely support that.
Other questions? I probably asked. I'm sorry, go ahead, Dale.
I didn't have my button pushed there, but I was just kind of curious on the process. Do you... When you look at these, are you you're trying to apply that formula of how much do they demonstrate, like for the McFarland, Richie McFarland, they sort of, do they give you some tally as to how many Newmarket residents they serve, or how
Yeah, they do give us a tally, and I could tell you what we give to them does not come close to equaling what do they give to us.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Mm-hmm. I have to, I mean, really the reduction is what we can afford at the end of the day. And this is for any of these agencies, because you usually get funding from other sources too, not just from the municipalities.
Right. No, I understand. I just you mentioned how the process worked, but I just was looking for a little more detail.
Councilor Weinstein.
And just in case anybody is unfamiliar with it, basically the way it works is any child under the age of 3 who needs services gets it.
What's it?
Any sort of special ed services.
No, you're talking about Richie McFarland.
Gets service.
Yeah.
So they get service, whether they can pay for it or not. We were never asked to contribute funds.
But you're talking about one specific...
Yeah, for Richie McFarland.
There you go.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
So, and so that's just how it works. So it's a huge benefit to, you know, I was one family. And when we look at our preschool program in town, those are primarily special ed kids. And so they don't enter the school system until they're three. But before they're three, Richie McFarland provides the service. So it's pretty phenomenal.
Thank you. Anything else?
That is it.
Yeah.
Do you want to know the magic number unofficially?
Sure.
So, with the reductions that we made, it brought the general fund budget to $7,128,151.
I'm sorry, say that one more time.
$7,128,151. Special revenues to $1,065,220. And the enterprise funds to $3,320,206, for a total of $11,508,877. My proposed budget was $11,581,761. So the tax impact would be 9 cents, or 1.44% increase in the tax rate. And that's usually something that, you know, and we're still using this year's net assessed evaluation too, so we've been seeing increases there.
I think it's just a testament. I mean, over the last years, there's been just like cutting at fat. That without like structural change, like, we're not going to see a lot of.
And then, as we keep saying, the MRI report showing we're pretty lean. We're very lean running.
Absolutely.
Right. So if we can find ways to increase efficiency, even if we're not cutting the budget. If we can increase efficiency and be more resilient so that we can sustain reduced spending over the long term, reduced over what it would be if we were less proactive, that would be a good thing.
So next steps?
Next step is on Wednesday, a week from today, I will come in with an amendment for the resolution to adopt the budget with this number. I ask the council to amend it. If not, it'll be higher. And then you adopt the budget, and that's it. Then it goes to the Budget Committee on November 28th.
And what's the date for the public hearing?
December 12th, it looks like, right now.
It's right around the corner.
Yeah, which is early. I mean, it's very early.
And then the meeting after that, you'll be having the ordinance for the first reading of the ordinance.
That would be my recommendation, yeah.
Bill's very concerned about that ordinance.
Want to keep on pace.
Yeah. I just want to make sure we have an insurance policy there, though.
Yeah.
So I have a work trip that day.
The 28th?
The next meeting.
Okay.
I still want, like, it's going to go on the ballot saying 6-0.
It has to be adopted and sent to the Budget Committee by November 15th. I think your recommendation could always be amended later.
Okay.
You could say, we could put in a, you could request that. Well, somebody could request that we amend the resolution.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I still want to see, like, you know how it looks when the.
Yeah.
Yeah. Any other comments?
Oh, and the other thing is, we all have to come up with a default budget for the council, which is pretty much going to look like this budget because it's last year's, minus any new expenditures. So that what you'll see is the transfer from those funds from the buildings and grounds individual back into the finance individual. So, plus most of it's contractual that we have, like the bonds and the health insurance. So, but we'll have that shortly as well.
Great. One other comment, if I could. So November 1st is candidates night. I believe it's at 7 o'clock, here, downstairs.
So November 1st.
November 1st. So Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Yep. Before our next meeting. So.
Candidates for all offices will be there, to include President of the United States.
Yeah, for our local candidates. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Councilor Weinstein. Any other comments?
Main Street is open.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Main Street is open.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, thanks.
So next meeting is November 2nd. They've already taken us off TV.
I just noticed that.
So I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
We are adjourned.
Thanks.
What happens to the minutes here?
We're going to do it by tape.
I love the sounds.
Well, they're going to lose some minutes.
We can figure that out.
They can lose minutes at the end there.
More detail.
Who's recording?
It's
We're Doug, and we're trying a new part-time person. So I think that could be it.
You know what's
going on? I don't think we have any.
No, we're waiting for the police, the Stratton police to still investigate.
And did our Facebook page disappear?
Hi, we're adjourned. That was so you can turn off. Thanks.
DDoS attack from
dying. Must have gone to the bathroom or something.
What'd you say?
Yeah, I can't.
DDoS attack of
which
dying.
For the town.
Oh, was it?
I got it today.
I'm sorry, for channel.